you're affiliated with PhilHac Basketball. Yes. So, I mean, before getting to PhilHac represent, how did you get your start into the Filipino basketball community? Like, I know you probably played in those Filipino basketball leagues when you were little, as much as all of us did.
Yeah.
And how did that turn out to be, like, basketball becoming, you know, your life, ball is life?
Pretty much. Well, yeah, just, yeah, as all of us did, we've all played in those little PhilHac house leagues, whatever house leagues there are across the GTA. And for me, that transition into coaching, as I got older, I think my last great playing run was maybe 4 or 5 years ago. We were playing 17 under. We won 7 championships that year.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
We had a great team. Shout out Krishan, shout out Irwin, shout out Calvin Epistola, University of Ottawa.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we had a great team. And then our core, we just stuck together for so long. And as we got older, I transitioned into coaching them because I'm not going to lie, I'm not in the best physical shape.
That's all right. I mean,
but you know, my mind was still there. So then I used that to get into coaching. And from coaching, I just branched out everywhere. I've done stuff with Mega City Basketball Youth in the summers. I coached at a summer camp with the Hoop Factory. And from there, just Mega City, they brought me countless basketball opportunities, I'm not going to lie. Mm-hmm. Shout out Mega City Basketball, best basketball league in the city. What league do you play for? You know what it is.
I know. Mega City is getting some noise around the GTA, and it's been pretty good. So, I mean, did you ever thought that, you know, despite the complications with, you know, how your health was, did you ever thought that you're going to be turning from a basketball player into a coach?
Well, for me, coaching, it was never in my plans. Mm-hmm.
What was your, did you have a calling in a sense that, hey, like, did you ever had like a moment or like a calling in your life saying, hey, that basketball was something that you're going to have for, like, you know, no matter what it was, what form of, you know, either coaching or training or some form of way that you're going to be involved in basketball for a very long time or for most of your life?
Well, yeah, that didn't really hit me until maybe a few years ago. But yeah, as a kid, everyone's like, oh, I want to play NBA, I want to do this, I want to do that.
Yeah.
Like, to be honest with you, when I was a little kid, I thought I was going to be 6'8".
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm vertically challenged. Shout out Filipino jeans.
Nothing you do about that.
Was there a point in your life when you're like, when you started maybe coaching, you started training, you're like, wait, I can see myself doing this. And I can see myself doing this now and for like maybe a long time. Did you ever have like a moment like that?
Yeah, I think it was probably about the time I started working with Mega City. Because before that, it was like, I knew I loved basketball, but like, I guess I really didn't do my research and find out all the opportunities that there were out there.
Yeah.
But yeah, since going with Mega City, they opened up my eyes and they put me in so many different things that like I'm just very grateful for. Yeah. Like Crown League, mm-hmm. Shout out Nike Crown League. Like, that was a great experience. Also, I was volunteering at the NBA D League, now G League Showcase in Mississauga, and we're going to do that again this year, so I'm excited for that. And yeah, just opportunities are endless in the basketball community now that I learned about that.
Yeah, so you're pretty much well-rounded around this basketball scene in Toronto.
Yeah.
So what have you been doing with like the younger generation, especially over the Filipino youth? Because I know a few episodes ago, we talked about the growth of Filipino basketball. What are you trying to do to help, you know, make sure that, you know, Filipinos, or not even just Filipinos, a lot of kids are still not, you know, on their computers playing video games, but stay active and play basketball?
Well, you see, nowadays there's so many programs, there's so many outlets there for people to be successful, as opposed to back then, there weren't many basketball-oriented things to do. But yeah, now I'm just, I don't know, as a way when I was growing up, I had good and bad coaches. Now I guess I'm trying to just share my knowledge and share my experiences for the younger generation that are trying to do their thing, you know?
Do you have like I felt like when I coach or when I train, like I've always had what's your vision? Do you have a vision in terms of how you want, you know, kids, if you had, you know, to train this many kids or you had kids that are under you, do you have a vision and a goal for them to kind of see where you want to take them or where you want to see them?
No, yeah, the sky's the limit. Like, to me, I love training because I just like to see, I like seeing people getting better. I like seeing like the no-name kid nobody knew about. If he just puts in the work, I like to see him one day be a star, some stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
And to me personally, I think with one of the first Filipinos in the NBA is going to be from the Toronto area, just because Toronto basketball scene is very diverse. There are a lot of Filipino kids being successful in the AAU, grassroots, OBA level, doing their thing, not just Filipino leagues.
So are you saying like a pure Filipino?
A pure Filipino.
Pure Filipino from the GTA might be entering the NBA for the first time?
Yeah, he will be coming from the NBA.
Yeah, I think the first.
No, I can see
if, if he's not straight from the Philippines, I think the first pure Filipino in the NBA will be from Toronto.
Yeah.
That's a big statement. That's like, a heavy statement right there.
Mark your calendar. When's it? August 31, 2017.
Mark it down. We'll have this episode bookmarked and make sure we have that.
What do you feel like so far right now? What's been going good in terms of, you know, Filipino basketball? What do you feel like it's going good right now? And what do you feel like it can improve more in terms of, you know, what you see so far from your experience? Since
Right now, it's just growing and growing. Like, there's so much more tournaments, so much more different clubs from different areas than there were before. Like, back in the day, there was just maybe like one or two or three clubs that were competing every tournament. Now we have tournaments 10 teams deep per division, and like everyone has a chance. So just to see the number of coaches rising, number of programs rising, just the overall level is just getting better.
Is there something that you see that they could improve more, or something that you'd like to see more happen in the next few years or in the future?
Well, improvements, I would just say some of the coaches, like, I'm going to be straight up. Some of the coaches are just...
In general.
Yeah, they
We felt that too, because me and PJ, we coach kids too, and we feel like the quality of coaches need, or there's supposed to be either a regulation on how you really should coach, because I feel like some coaches back, even little kids, they force them, you know, they would shout at them, and they would, where you got to, you know, make sure in the beginning, you got to make sure they make them love the sport before, because they're just going to continue getting better. But you got to make them love the sport.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Because, right now, a lot of parents a lot of coaches are volunteer parents or brothers and sisters and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And they just really, they want to see their kid or their brother happy. So they just focus on winning. But what I want to see improve is I want to see coaches focus on development, fundamentals, like footwork, like throughout. I did scorekeeping for Mabuhay Cup, and just the amount of things that are expected of the little kids is not really ideal.
Sure. Yeah.
Like, a coach is telling a kid to do 2-to-1 full court press, set screens, do that, but like, they don't even need that at like the Tykes level.
Exactly.
At the Tykes level, all a kid really needs to do is like learn how to dribble and shoot.
Exactly.
And that's like, that's too much in their head. They just want to have, like, I know one coach, I know we broadcasted, I was on a camera, and he was just focusing on the kids, saying like, honestly, just don't worry about the defense. I mean, just have some fun. Obviously, do the proper, like, basic defense. Block their shots. You got to try to dive for some steals. But, I mean, just ultimately have fun when you're playing basketball. Mm.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, we're closing up. But, like, one thing that we want to get from you, mindset-wise, if you were to give advice to kids nowadays that are, you know, growing up and pursuing basketball or into basketball, what are some of the advice you'd like to give them?
Well, for an upcoming basketball player, just focus on your fundamentals, focus on your footwork. Because from there, that's the basis, right? For me, footwork's the most important thing, because if your feet can't move, then the rest of your body is pretty much obsolete, right? It starts from there. Build a good base and go on from there.
And I know we got to go, but real quick, what is next for Mark? What is next for you? Is coaching be your end game plan, or like, is there something else that you really, really want to do to help out, even just in basketball or just, you know, in general?
Well, yeah, coaching, right now I don't see a professional career in it, but for me it's always going to be a lifelong thing. If there's a kid, hey, you want to get in the gym and work out? Sure. But right now, for the near future at least, I'll be in school right now. I'm at Humber College taking sports management, going to enter my first year there. And after that, I'm going to see where that takes me.
That's awesome.
Right. That's great. Anyways, Mark, the next up in sports management, check out for him on his team in Toronto, Phil Lack.